sports fans, thanks for joining us. With Steve Kerr and Clark Kellogg, this is Kevin Harlan. And it's time for NBA basketball on 2K Sports. We've got a chance now for our starting lineup from point guard to center. This game should be a good one. Marvin Williams and Jay Rich in the backcourt. You've got Shaw. A big game for this young man making his NBA debut. Then it's Goodrich, and it's Strawberry in at the power forward position. And for the home team, screen. Swift, the pass to O'Brien. Here is Shaw. Six to shoot. Now the pass to Strawberry. And he finishes nicely on the layup.
Well, the number one priority for a defense when you face this guy is to keep him getting anywhere from the basket because he's just so strong as a finisher.
And also, there aren't many players better at anticipating an opponent's next move, waiting for his moment and then jumping in the way of a pass to come up with a steal. He's got that mastery.
Chase. He's covered by Goodrich. Pass to Chase. With the lead pass. Just five to shoot. Here's Skinner. They get the rebound. Passes it to Chase. Over Strawberry. And the shot's good from Chase.
Well, that's one way he can finish, but not the only way. He's got a lot of tricks up his sleeve.
And we're about a minute and a half into the first quarter. Swift defended by Strickland. Here's Swift. And he's off on his first shot of the game.
You know, that mid-range jump shot is not his strong suit, even when he gets a good look like that.
And it's sent back by Swift. And count it, the shot is good. He'll go to the free throw line. A free throw off from Strickland, but they recover it. He passes it to Johnson. The second chance effort. It's rebounded by Strawberry. The first quarter of action, 2 minutes in. Let's catch up with Doris from the sideline.
I briefly spoke with the home team's head coach. He said they'll have to do a good job moving their feet on the defensive end or they'll get dunked on all night. He told me that they are very aware of the slashers and finishers they're facing and will try to turn them into jump shooters. Let's see how successful they are, Kevin.
All right, Doris. Chase. No good. Excellent defense from Swift. O'Brien the pass to Swift. First quarter of basketball, just over 2.5 minutes play. And it's Graham missing. Gone 2-6 in the field. And it is first down with a nice jam.
And he operates so well close to the bucket. There's nothing he likes more than seeing an opening inside.
gone 2 of 3 from the field. The pass to Shaw. He dishes it to Graham. Strawberry defended by Strickland. The feed to Graham. Pass to Strawberry. Shot clock at 6. Graham. And it's blocked. There's 1:47 left to play in the first quarter. Skinner defended by Shaw. Passes to Strickland. Blanketed by the D. He fights to the rim for the win. 6 points for him.
He's feeling it here to start the game. That's 3 out of 4 already.
Clark David struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a little bit of cottonmouth here. Dry spell for sure.
Yeah, he definitely saw some things that were not working for them out there. And now he's going to make some adjustments.
I'm not sure what it was, but he clearly wanted something to change out there.
We've got 1:23 left here in the first quarter. O'Brien, the pass to Holmes. 6 on the shot clock. The dish to Green. Sinks the three-pointer.
You can't leave him alone, especially from long range.
59 seconds left to play in the first quarter. And there's the pass to Warner. Booth, guarded by Fox. Here's Booth. A picture-perfect screen play, and the jumper's good.
They can't afford to give him that kind of look.
Well, it came off a good screen, but still, as a defender, you got to fight over the top of that.
Clock management. This is where, Steve, they can get a 2-for-1.
Yeah, I think it makes sense. As long as the first one's a good one, and now you play D, you get the ball back, one more shot.
Kicks it to Graham. That's the free flyer. That's good. Graham's got 6.
That shot becomes effortless for him when the D is so relaxed. They got to get more intense.
And so here's the home team. 5 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. Williamson, the pass to Shelton. He feeds it to Blake. He passes to Williamson. Clock at 6. Here's Warner. Soft touch off the glass.
I'll tell you what, the defenders didn't even get a sniff of him on that move to the hoop.
With 1 on the clock, Warner simply drains it in at the buzzer.
And an ideal finish to the quarter for them as he drains it at the buzzer.
Boy, I like the fact he didn't rush it at all. Fantastic shot.
First quarter wrapping up here, and Clark, it's a tie ball game. We'll get things started in the second quarter when we return. And so far, it's been a closely contested game as we get the second quarter up and going. Guys, what's your take on the home team so far?
And they're really keying in on getting as many good shots inside the lane as possible. They're doing a nice job of not just settling for outside looks.
Yep, I agree. I mean, they're working it inside and doing it with intention and purpose.
And let's now go to the sideline to catch up here with Doris Burke. Doris?
Guys, one of the big surprises on draft night was seeing Nerlens Noel out of Kentucky, a player who's long been talked about as the favorite to go number 1, fall all the way to number 6. And then he got traded to Philadelphia. His recovery from ACL surgery, clearly a concern for teams. But he's in a great situation in Philly and playing with a chip on his shoulder. Asked about his feelings on the teams that passed on him, he said, "I'm going to make them pay. Kevin, we'll see."
And sometimes he takes that motivation from the doubters. A good way to motivate you, certainly. Thanks, Doris. 5 to shoot. Expanding his range. Cannot hit. Here's Fordham. Dishes it to Blake. Pass to Shelton. Passes it to Warner. There's the three. 5 points in the game.
Well, he made a nice little bounce pass there. We call that the pocket pass, and he did it well.
Another play just over a minute of basketball here in the second quarter. They set the pick. Novak, the pass to Arnold. Feeds to Goodrich. And he was 5 on the way up. 2 free throws now for him.
You know, something that I've seen and that I've noticed is how well he reads an opponent's eyes. He just seems to anticipate exactly where he's going to go with the ball.
That's a good observation by you, Steve, and that's exactly why so many of his steals come from picking off passes. He really thinks the game out and usually stays one step ahead.
He misses the free throw. The second from the line. We're about a minute and a half into the second quarter now. Second quarter of action, about a minute and a half played. Down low, here's Shelton. Right in with a nice touch off the glass.
They are not rotating nearly quickly enough on defense down low. Got to get quicker there.
And even if it costs them some foul trouble, I mean, they need to start putting some bodies on bodies. Be physical.
Here is Novak. Looking for his first basket still on this one. Here's Goodrich. Plenty of room to knock down the shot. Gotten both of their three-point attempts to go down here in the second quarter. And the pass to Warner. Pass to Graves. From outside the arc. The shot's good from Warner. He's got 8.
Great outside shooting fueling this one.
And the defense feels like that. They just haven't been able to slow him down.
It's an 8-point differential. And a chance here to catch up with the fourth member of our crew, Doris Burke. Hi, Doris.
Well, gentlemen, a bold draft day trade for the Philadelphia 76ers. Trading away their all-star point guard, Drew Holiday, for the rights to 6th pick overall, Nerlens Noel, and a first-round pick in the loaded class of 2014. And for the new front office, it's a clear direction. Go young and build from the ground up. The Sixers will likely take a step back this season, but the experts all love the initiative with this move. Not content to be an average team, guys, they're looking to shake things up.
Doris, a lot of promise on this team. We'll see how they develop. Back to Johnson. Passes it to Warner. 5 on the clock. From past the arc. Shot misses. Gone 2 of 3 from the field here to open the second quarter. There's the pass to Swift. And in the second quarter, a little under 3.5 minutes played already. Launches a 3. Rebound by Johnson. going 3-for-4 with the long range bombs here in the second quarter. And Johnson missing again.
And that's a shot he had to take.
For sure, it was a good decision, just poor execution.
Back to Goodrich. He passes to Swift. Misses the three. Gone 4-6 in the field here in the second. Pass to Warner. Back to Johnson. Pass to Warner. They set the screen. That one falls down off Johnson's feet. He's got it in.
Well, when you think about instant offense, his name comes to mind immediately. Doesn't take much for him to get it going and run off a string of buckets.
And something else everybody loves about him is his ability to do the sensational and spectacular. His dunks simply defy description at times.
The pass to Swift. He kicks it to Goodrich. That's good. Goodrich has got his third basket of the night right there.
He really made that mismatch pay off. The defender giving up that much size isn't going to be able to put up much resistance near the basket.
Warner defended by Swift. Johnson outside. Fades away. Will not go. This is off the front iron. So we've reached the end of the first half of play. The home team up 7. And coming up after the break, it'll be Damon Bruce breaking down all the highlights from the first half of play.
It's time for the Sunday night halftime report. At the midway point, the home team is playing very well. And defensively, they've done a good job grabbing rebounds, limiting second chances. And the visitors still keeping at it. They're scoring at ease. Is it great offense or weak defense? Whatever it is, they're lighting up that scoreboard. Now let's get back over to Kevin Harlan and the rest of our crew as the second half gets underway.
And welcome back to New York City as we look at an enchanting view of Lady Liberty. It's been one outstanding game from Warner.
Yeah, he played a very mature first half offensively, just finding gaps and making good decisions, getting into the defense and knocking down shots.
Well, the way he played that first half, that's exactly what we're talking about when we say offensive efficiency.
Here's Strickland, and they're going to count the bucket and send him to the line. It could be a three-point play.
For somebody at the one spot, he's unusually powerful.
Yeah, Clark, I mean, there aren't many point guards who can match his strength.
And this is his second trip to the line in the game. Has been fun to watch in this game. They're at 57%. Oh, Bryant, the pass to Swift. Here's Strawberry. And so he draws the foul on the shot. A trip to the line to shoot two.
And the defense fouling there to prevent that layup, forcing two free throws here.
Nice job that time of attacking the paint and drawing the contact. They'll take that.
The first one falls. He's perfect from the line this time. Gone 4-6 from outside the arc tonight. Chase Flanders, defended by Shaw. Offensive rebound, Flanders. And good work on the boards to pick up the second chance points.
It's a +5 advantage for them in the rebounding category after that board.
Very steady work they've been doing on the interior, no question. And that's, I think, the main reason they have this lead.
Pass to Goodrich. Six on the shot clock. Goes up the baseline. He squares up and sinks it. Goodrich has got 9 points.
Look out, guys. I mean, I think there's a lot more where that came from. When he gets it going like this, it is not easy to slow him down.
Just about a minute and a half into the third quarter of basketball. Johnson outside. And that goes out of bounds. And they'll keep possession. Puts the lead pass in front of him. And it gives the mayor up on the scoreboard. Looks like it does. Very passive defense.
But the finish was anything but passive.
No, he hammered that down, pardon. Superb above the rim action. Well, they're getting way too many easy shots in the paint. So this timeout is specifically for that reason. You got to tighten up the defense and start to make it harder for that offensive team.
I know it's easier said than done, but right now it just doesn't seem like the necessary effort is good.
Around 60% of the night. Amazing work offensively so far. O'Brien the pass to Goodrich. They set the pick. Blocked.
Such a solid performance from us inside. The rebound has been terrific.
Yeah, that's just one of the few things that have gone their way today.
Shaky defense down low. Again, it's been a mismatch in the paint.
I'm sure they didn't go into this one expecting to get battered like they have inside.
Passes it to Strawberry. He dishes it to Goodrich. Six to shoot. Just under 2.5 minutes into the third quarter now. That's good. Goodrich has got 4 points this quarter. Gotten 4 of the first 5 second half shots to fall. 80% since the break. Back to Johnson. He passes to Chase. Flanders, defended by Shaw. And it's going to be 2 free throws. Drew contact on the shot.
Yeah, nice body control there. Narrowly missing the shot. Would have been a 3-point play.
Had a free look at it after the foul. Nice play.
2 shots.
And he knocks down the first one. And that one goes in. 2 from the line that time. Right around 3 minutes into the second half. O'Brien the pass to Graham. No good on the 3.
And that'll increase their rebound advantage. They've definitely been winning that battle on the board.
And the main thing is they haven't allowed many second chance opportunities. And that is always going to allow you to maintain your lead.
Just under 3.5 minutes played here in the third quarter. Here's O'Brien. and too long on the shot.
Now he had a defender draped all over. Not really the best shot there.
Well, not the shots you hope for when it's well contested like that.
Flanders, defended by Holmes. Just four to shoot. Inside, boom. Beat the shot clock, but it's off the mark.
I thought he rushed it a little bit, guys, because he had a clean look, just lost his focus.
The pass to Fox. The feed to Graham. Shoots the three, and that one's good. Graham's got his third bucket of the night.
You know, defensively, you cannot forget about him. It gave him a wide open look there.
Gone 5 of 7 from the field in the third quarter. Let's see if they can keep it up. Seconds left here in the third quarter. Williamson, the pass to Chase. Fires it up, and the jumper is good. 8 points for him. Gone 3 of 6 in the third quarter, 50% from the field. Graham, the pass to Holmes. Now the dish to Graham. Passes it to Strawberry. Puts up a three, and the shot is good. There's the triple. Got it all in time, but it's no good. And as we end the third quarter, a double-digit deficit will make it tough to come back. The home team up by 10. And fourth quarter basketball will be coming your way on 2K Sports right after this. Well, welcome back as we get set to start the fourth. It's been fun to watch in this game. They're at 57%. The pass to Shaw. Swift, defended by Chase. Pass to Swift from downtown. Shot's good.
They're going back to the three-point shot over and over and over.
That was the ninth straight point from behind the arc, Clark. It feels like they're finding the holes in this defense.
And so here's the home team.
Such a great focus as a shooter. He's a very frustrating player to guard because unless you actually block his shot, you are not going to get in his head and affect him.
You know, something else I think about when I see these guys, he's a real headache to have to defend one-on-one. I mean, he's got all of the game that makes it tough for his defender.
Shot clock at 5. Oh, Bryant, the pass to Swift. And beyond the arc, and then some.
That's now a dozen straight points coming off wide-open three-pointers.
You know what it looks like to me out there, guys? I mean, it looks like All-Star Weekend out there. We know how much defense is played there. It's actually defense during the All-Star Weekend, no deep.
And here is Johnson following the three from Swift. Johnson outside. Excellent D from O'Brien.
And his mechanics are just all out of whack now. He just has no feel for his shot.
Well, his numbers certainly back that fact up. I mean, he has gone ice cold here.
He passes to Swift. Takes a three. That one goes.
And at the last 5 makes, all have been from long range.
Yeah, and the defense has not done a good job of pressing in and denying. I mean, they're hanging back, playing on their heels. They're not being the aggressors here, and the offense is taking advantage of it.
And here is Johnson after the three-pointer from Swift. Johnson, the pass to Strickland. back to Johnson. Here's Skinner. And they come right back with their own three-pointer.
Incredible. Only took them a few seconds to answer the three ball with one of their own.
Let's keep this thing going, guys. I love seeing a three-point battle like this.
Get this update now from Doris Burke, who's across the way on the sideline.
Hi, Kevin. The head coach for the visiting team had some instruction for his guys during that last break. He gave his guys the green light to keep firing from downtown, telling them, listen, I like the work you're doing out there. Keep finding those gaps on the perimeter. They're giving us open shots.
Thank you, Doris. A little over 2.5 minutes have passed here in the fourth quarter. Goodrich, defended by Chase. It's stolen by Johnson. Pass it to Chase. But Green. Gotten all three of their shots to drop here in the fourth quarter. They came out of the break on a roll. There's the pass to Swift. Kicks it to Goodrich. Pass to O'Brien. Here's Swift. Hits the three-point bomb.
Man, he has been their unquestioned leader offensively this quarter. He did not look too happy about some of the things he saw on the court. So I would expect some changes here.
I think it's the right move, quite honestly. I mean, they just didn't look sharp or at their best out there. So take the time out and give yourself a chance to regroup.
That's going to be over and back. Not watching for the line that time.
Well, let's forgive him for that turnover. It's the only one he's committed today.
There's 1:54 left in the fourth quarter. O'Brien with the pass to Swift. And two free throws coming up as he misses that one. Drawing the whistle and a lot of contact here.
Yeah, the defender draped all over.
Pretty plain and simple. Got him good there.
Building in a big hurry.
Gone 5-9 when they put up the three-point shots in it. One more left in the game. Skinner defended by Strawberry. One-on-one fast break. Yes!
points.
That's beyond huge, Steve. I mean, they needed that bucket desperately.
Gone 1-2 from three-point range here in the fourth. Johnson outside. He passes it to Chase. Back to Johnson. Here's Skinner. He's off from three. Gotten absolutely red hot shooting the ball here in the fourth. A perfect 6-for-6. And good from Swift. This is a huge possession.
We've got to execute under pressure. We're going to see what they're made of. Boy, poor defense at both ends. It kind of reminds me of your team's part.
Well, not exactly. We did give a little better effort. I mean, neither squad really digging in at that end. At least we tried to play defense. The intentional foul.
Yeah, you got to freeze the clock. I mean, that's the enemy in this situation.
A few misses at the line and they're in good shape.
You can't beat the problem.
And that hurts as he doesn't get the first one to fall. Trying to focus now on the second. From the line, and that makes it a three-point lead. There's 21 seconds left to play here in the fourth. Now here's Goodrich, defended by Chase. Goodrich, that's good.
Ah, the turnaround jumper, that was a thing of beauty.
And now they finally stop the clock. Put them up by two. So he gets them both, and it's a three-point game.
Huge free throws there, and that could be the difference. It will force more than likely a desperation three-point attempt.
To tie it up. Can't get the 3-4. And they go to the intentional foul. Second one is good. We both at the line. It's a 5-point game.
And that's exactly how you close the game out. Those free throws were very efficient.
And so they get the victory here at home. They pulled off this win, Clark, with respectable performances on both ends of the floor.
Yeah, I think it was just really a nice overall effort, Kevin.
And now for Clark Kellogg, Steve Kerr, and Doris Burke, this is Kevin Harlan thanking you for joining us tonight on our presentation of NBA on 2K Sports. Now our Jordan Player of the Game.